The Schluter-Curti drain can easily be installed within a concrete boxout. This video demonstrates the preparation and installation of a Curti drain flange within such an application. Let's take a look at what's provided in the drain flange box. A drain flange, a template as a guide for core hole size, foam spacers, Curti Carrick inside and outside corners, and Curti Seal PS and MV pipe and mixing valve seals. The grate assembly is sold separately. The Curti drain can be used with either a mortar base or the Schluter Curti Shower prefabricated shower trays. The drain is available in different materials, including PVC, ABS, and stainless steel. This video will demonstrate the installation of a PVC flange. All plumbing connections should be made by a qualified person in accordance with local building and fire codes effective in your region. Pre-construction meetings have taken place and the workflow established between the plumber and tile installer. The plumber will begin the work. The first stage of plumbing has been run and the riser pipe secured into place. Establish the height of the riser pipe. Cut the pipe. Place the foam spacers on the flange. And dry fit the Curti drain. The spacers are designed to position the drain at the appropriate elevation for the Curti shower tray, which will be installed by the tile installer later in the process. Boxouts in concrete floors must be filled with dry pack mortar or concrete prior to installing the drain. A pipe coupling or similar can be used as a form when filling the boxout. The recommended opening diameter is 4¾ inch to 5 inches. This will provide enough space to house the drain body, while ensuring proper support for the tile assembly. You can verify there is enough space by dry fitting the form around the drain before filling the box out. It is recommended to maintain the opening the full depth of the concrete slab for convenience and to minimize the risk of making the opening too shallow. In this example, the tile installer is filling the box out with dry pack mortar. Tamp and level the box out with the form to make sure it is level and centered for the plumber's next steps. Allow the mortar to dry. The plumber resumes the next steps and connects the Curti drain. Place the foam spacers onto the drain flange. Again, this will set the drain to the appropriate elevation for the shower tray. Using PVC cleaner, primer and glue, install the Curti drain, making the connections to the riser pipe within the coupler. Check the drain for level. The tile installer will resume work on the shower assembly. Remove the center section of the Curti shower tray. Remove the foam spacers set by the plumber from the Curti drain. Dry fit the center section and shower tray. It can be helpful to mark around the tray as a guide for the thin-set mortar application. Make sure the substrate is clean and free of debris. Apply thin-set mortar to the top and bottom of the detached center section of the shower tray. Slide the center section into place under the drain to ensure solid and uniform support of the bonding flange. Clean away excess mortar. Recheck the drain for level. The Curti shower tray can now be installed. Apply any of our Schluter thin-set mortars or an unmodified thin-set mortar to the substrate using a 1/4 inch by 3/8 inch or 3/8 by 3/8 square or U-notch trowel. Set the shower tray and solidly embed into the thin-set mortar. Next, install the Curti Board SC shower curbs in the same manner as previously demonstrated with the shower tray. Make sure to apply thin-set mortar to all points of contact. The waterproofing connections can now be made using Curti waterproofing accessories in conjunction with thin-set mortar. Next, the Curti collar is installed. Using the flat side of the trowel, apply thin-set mortar over the bonding flange and within the recessed area of the shower tray surrounding the drain. Then, comb additional mortar using the notch side of the trowel. Center the included Curti collar over the drain flange and embed using the flat side of the trowel or a drywall taping knife. Make sure this connection is secure. Clean the excess mortar from the bonding flange. Complete the waterproofing assembly using Curti accessories in the same manner, maintaining 2-inch overlaps at all junctions. The installation of the Curti drain within a concrete box out is now complete. If you still have questions, please contact our customer support specialists. For more information on Schluter products, visit Schluter.com or check out our YouTube channel to view our videos.